Hello viewers, welcome to Newsweek South Asia, a show where we'll provide you fresh insights into South Asia's geopolitical, strategic and security situation. Let's take a look at the headlines first. Terrorists target Indian Air Force convoy in Jammu and Kashmir. Clash erupts between police and protesters in park-occupied Jammu and Kashmir. And struggle against enforced disappearances in Balochistan continues. The recent terrorist attack on an Indian Air Force convoy in the Poonch district of Jammu and Kashmir underscores the ongoing security challenges in the region. Despite the swift retaliation by Air Force personnel, the loss of life and injuries are tragic reminders of the persistent threat posed by terrorism. Security forces have launched a thorough search operation to apprehend the perpetrators, highlighting the urgent need for a robust response to such attacks. Our report.
On May 4th, terrorists targeted an Indian Air Force convoy in the Poonch district of Jammu and Kashmir. In the ensuing exchange of fire, Air Force personnel retaliated, but unfortunately, five individuals sustained gunshot wounds. Despite being rushed to the nearest military hospital, one of them tragically passed away later. Security forces launched a large-scale search operation in the surrounding areas, questioning numerous locals to track down the attackers. The army released sketches of two suspected terrorists believed to be involved in the attack on May 6th and announced a reward of 20 lakhs rupees for any information leading to their capture. Following the incident, defense experts have emphasized the need for a strong response.
As long as the sleeper cells exist in Jammu and Kashmir, these sorts of incidents will continue to happen. And they look for an opportunity. You see, the advantage with these attackers or these terrorists are, the timing is with them. They know when to attack, where to attack, how to attack. This is not known to defender. So this is the game being played by Pakistan. And it's my recommendation that time now has come that within 25 kilometers from the border, whichever our Pakistan outposts, military outposts, we should target them, use our heavy artillery, and just bombard them. If the matter escalates, let it be so. Let it be so. But Pakistan must get a message that the cost of inflicting terrorism on India, the cost will be very high.
In the past few years, the Indian government has launched various projects in Jammu and Kashmir to boost economic growth, enhance infrastructure, and uplift the living standards of its people. These efforts have been specially prioritized following the repeal of Article 370 in August 2019, which had provided special autonomous status to the region. However, certain terror groups supported by Pakistan frequently try to sabotage these development endeavors due to their frustration with ongoing progress. Resorting to violence, they aim to disrupt stability and reconciliation efforts in the area.
यहाँ पर देखा जाए तो एक तरफ इलेक्शन का माहौल है, दूसरी जम्मू कश्मीर में बड़ी शांति आ गई है. टूरिस्ट जा रहे हैं, होटल फुल हैं, लोगों को आमदनी हो रही है, काम धंधा मिला हुआ है, स्कूल खुले हुए हैं, कॉलेज खुले हुए हैं, पढ़ाई हो रही है. ये बात रास नहीं आ रही. और यहाँ पर मैं ये कहूँगा, ये पाकिस्तान की जो कायराना हरकत है, वो यहाँ पर कहीं ना कहीं गेम खेल रहे हैं.
टेररिस्ट डिसरप्शंस ऑफ इलेक्शंस इन कश्मीर आर रेप्रिहेंसिबल एक्ट्स दैट एम टू अंडरमाइन द डेमोक्रेटिक प्रोसेस एंड इंस्टिल फियर अमंग द पॉपुलर्स. They target the democratic process, which is meant to give people a voice and a peaceful means of expressing their political preferences.
जैसे ही लोकसभा के इलेक्शन या और कोई इलेक्शन आते हैं तो टेररिस्ट एक्टिविटी जो है वो तेज हो जाती है, क्योंकि पाकिस्तान नहीं चाहता कि यहाँ पे किसी तरीके की इलेक्शन हो और लोगों को ये लगे कि नॉर्मल सी आ गई है.
Terrorist disruptions of elections in Kashmir pose a significant challenge to the democratic process and the safety of the people in the region. These disruptions can involve threats, violence, or intimidation aimed at preventing voters from exercising their democratic rights. However, in response of terror conspiracy, authorities in the region have deployed increased security measures to protect polling stations, voters, and election officials. Additionally, efforts are being made to gather intelligence, track terrorist activities, and apprehend those responsible for attempting to disrupt the electoral process.
Let's move to Pakistan-occupied Jammu and Kashmir's Dadiyal, which recently witnessed a violent clash between police and residents amidst ongoing protests over inflation and power outages. The confrontation escalated when authorities imposed Section 144, leading protesters to advance their demonstration to May 10th. Shaukat Nawaz Mir declared a general strike condemning the authorities' actions. Political activists, including Amjad Ayub Mirza, condemned the violence. These events underscore the deep-seated grievances against the Pakistani government's exploitation and neglect in POJK, contributing to periodic protests and tensions in the region. A report.
May 9 witnessed a violent clash between police and residents of Dadiyal in Pakistan-occupied Jammu and Kashmir, resulting in several injuries. The confrontation stemmed from ongoing protests against soaring inflation and frequent power outages, with demonstrators originally planning for a May 11th rally. However, following the clash, authorities imposed Section 144, banning all activities in the area. In a retaliatory move, protesters advanced their demonstration to May 10th. Prior warnings to authorities against violence had been issued by the protesters. Shaukat Nawaz Mir, local leader and chairman of the POJK Traders Association, declared a general strike across POJK, commencing at midnight, condemning the defense forces' actions.
डुडियाल के अंदर पुरतशद्दद वाकयात जो हुकूमत और इंतजामिया की तरफ से आज किए गए हैं, उस हवाले से जो काल हमने 11 मई की दी हुई थी, उसको रिवर्स करते हुए 10 मई की काल पूरे आजाद कश्मीर और बिलखसूस मुजफ्फराबाद के अंदर अनाउंस करने जा रहा हूं, और कल पूरा आजाद कश्मीर, मेरी मुराद आज रात 12 बजे से पूरा आजाद कश्मीर बिलखसूस मुजफ्फराबाद मुकम्मल पहिया जाम और मुकम्मल शटर डाउन होगा। तमाम अहलियाने कश्मीर से मेरी ये अपील होगी कि अपने हक की खातर बाहर निकलें। अगर आज आप बाहर ना निकले, फिर आपकी देर हो जाएगी और कभी भी आप अपना हक हासिल नहीं कर सकेंगे।
Several political activists, including Amjad Ayub Mirza, condemned the incident, emphasizing that violence against peaceful protesters in POJK is intolerable.
The people who are participating all across Pakistani occupied Jammu Kashmir have remained non-violent for the past 9 months. Not even a single flower pot has been broken. Not even a window glass has been shattered. Not even a single stone has been thrown at the police or law and order maintaining security forces. However, now the situation is getting out of hand. It is obvious that steps are being taken to crush the human rights civil disobedience movement.
The people of the region had previously sworn on their holy book Quran to resist oppression to their last breath. The demonstration on May 10th wasn't an isolated incident, as POJK inhabitants have frequently taken to the streets to demand their basic rights. They have consistently accused the Pakistani government of exploiting their natural resources and neglecting their everyday issues. This situation underscores the broader tensions and complexities within the region's socio-political dynamics. Human rights organizations have raised concerns about rights abuses by Pakistani security forces in POJK, including arbitrary arrests, extrajudicial killings, and restrictions on freedom of expression and assembly. These allegations have fueled resentment and led to periodic protests. Despite having its own legislative assembly and government, POJK's political autonomy is limited, with ultimate authority resting with Islamabad. This lack of genuine self-governance has led to frustrations among the local populace, who feel marginalized and disenfranchised.
The current situation in Pakistan-occupied Jammu and Kashmir underscores the deep-rooted grievances of the local population against the administration. The ongoing protests reveal a profound sense of frustration with the lack of accountability, transparency, and basic services in the region. The representatives elected by the people are unable to fulfill their responsibilities due to the absence of necessary funds, which exacerbates the already dire living conditions. Take a look.
Scores of representatives of union councils or municipalities in Pakistan-occupied Jammu and Kashmir held a protest recently outside the press club in Muzaffarabad to demand funds for the development of the region. They lamented they were elected by the public so that they can resolve their problems related to electricity, water, drainage, and roads. But they are unable to do so, as they receive no funds from the administration.
ये आपके अधारे पे करकर आपके अधारे की करकर्दगी पे आपकी गुड गवर्नेंस की करकर्दगी पे आप एक सवालिया निशान है। मैं आपसे मुतालबा करता हूँ जो आप जो जो साहब इख्तदार हैं जो आपने यहाँ पे इतनी बड़ी बड़ी गाड़ियाँ रखी हुई हैं इतने बड़े बड़े दफातर में बैठते हैं तो वो कम अज़ कम लोगों का ख्याल करें। यह किसी नुमाइंदे के साथ ज्यादती नहीं है बल्कि ये नुमाइंदे नहीं ये लोगों के साथ ज्यादती है जो वहाँ पे जो जो लोगों जो लोग दूर दराज इलाकों में रहते हैं उनके साथ आप ज्यादती कर रहे हैं।
For decades, general public in the illegally occupied territory of POJK have been protesting against the administration. The residents and the representatives blame the administration for underlying corruption in their departments and siphoning of the development funds they claim to have released for the region.
कभी आप एक आपके खिलाफ आप हुकूमत के खिलाफ एक महकमा रोडों पे होता है कभी दूसरा महकमा होता है आप तो गुड गवर्नेंस के दावे करते हैं कि किसी महकमे में किसी एक महकमे में भी तो हमें आप गुड गवर्नेंस दिखा देना। ये जो बल्दियाती सबसे बड़ा अदारा है 375 अरब रुपया हमारा फंड है बल्दियाती फंड इन अदारों के जरिए बल्दियाती अदारों के जरिए आज़ाद कश्मीर में ये तरक्याती फंड लगना चाहिए।
The protests against the administration are raging all across the illegally occupied territory. The residents lambasted the administration's claims of so-called good governance and highlighted the underlying corruption in each and every government department.
हर महकमे में हर जगह करप्शन है हर जगह रोला पड़ा हुआ है। हम बल्दियाती नुमाइंदे हम आपसे ये अपील करते हैं कि हमारा जो हक है हम आपसे भीख नहीं मांग रहे हमारा हक हमें दिया जाए।
Locals in POJK have long accused they are ruled by stooge authorities who only help Islamabad fill its treasuries through economic depredations. Saturated with regular power cuts, sky-high inflation, continuous violations of human rights and a host of other issues, the residents in the illegally occupied territory are up against the injustice and carrying out agitations all across the POJK region. The demonstrators are demanding accountability from the administrators and are calling for their rights to be recognized and respected. They reject the notion of being dependent on handouts and emphasize their right to fair governance and development funding. Moreover, they express frustration with what they perceive as puppet authorities serving the interests of Islamabad rather than addressing the needs of the local population. Overall, the protests in POJK reflect a deep-seated dissatisfaction with the current governance structures and highlight the urgent need for reforms to address corruption, mismanagement, and neglect of basic public services.
The struggle against enforced disappearances in Balochistan is deeply concerning. The families of the disappeared often face immense challenges in their quest for justice. They endure emotional trauma and uncertainty, not knowing the fate or whereabouts of their loved ones. Moreover, they often encounter obstacles when attempting to seek legal recourse or bring attention to their cases, facing intimidation and harassment. A report.
In Balochistan, various groups, including human rights organizations and activists, have documented numerous cases of enforced disappearances. The victims are often activists, journalists, students, or members of the Baloch nationalist movement perceived as threats to the state or its interests. The disappearances are typically accompanied by allegations of torture, extrajudicial killings, and other forms of human rights abuses. Families of the disappeared individuals are left in a state of uncertainty and anguish, not knowing the fate or whereabouts of their loved ones. This year, there have been some attacks on Balochistan's security forces and installations in the last few months. The Pakistani army is now using this as a justification for all of its illicit operations in the region.
بلوچستان میں جاری جنگ میں اس وقت جو سب سے زیادہ متاثرہ علاقے ہیں ان میں سے ایک مشقِ اواران بھی ہے۔ مشقِ کے علاقے تنگ میں ایک مہینہ پہلے فوجی چوکی پر حملہ ہوا۔ اس حملے کے بعد وہاں کے جو مقامی لوگ ہیں وہ سب سے زیادہ متاثر ہیں اور وہ ایک اذیت ناک اور ذلالت کی زندگی گزارنے پر مجبور ہیں۔ وہ اپنی معمولی زندگی اور روزگار اور کمائی کو چھوڑنے پر مجبور ہیں، جہاں صبح سویرے وہاں کے تمام مردوں کو جو ہے فوج اکٹھا کرتی ہے اور اپنی فوجی چوکیوں میں لے کر جاتی ہے، جہاں پر ان سے غلاموں کی طرح مزدوری کا کام کروایا جاتا ہے۔
In Balochistan, disappearances are often labeled by the government as self-inflicted, masking a long history of marginalization. Since Pakistan's annexation of the province in 1948, separatist movements have persisted, fueled by grievances over resource exploitation and lack of local benefit. Armed groups have clashed with Pakistani forces for independence, met with military retaliation. Balochistan has become a region of intense conflict with numerous families desperately searching for their missing relatives. Baloch women are bravely joining sit-in demonstrations, yet they are subjected to various forms of harsh treatment by state authorities. Similar incidents occurred with women who were protesting in Mashqai for their rights and safety.
دوران احتجاج ان خواتین کو ڈرایا گیا ہے، وہاں کے ڈیتھ اسکواڈ کے ہاتھوں ان کو دھمکایا گیا ہے، اور بڑی مشکل کے بعد ان خواتین کی ویڈیوز ہم تک پہنچی ہیں، اور ہم تمام لوگوں سے درخواست کرتے ہیں کہ ان خواتین کی، ان بے بس ماؤں اور بہنوں کی آواز بنے اور اس ریاستی جبر کے خلاف بلوچستان کے لوگوں کا ساتھ دیں۔
Baloch activists have been reaching out globally to various platforms, organizations, and individuals to draw attention to the challenges faced by the Baloch people. Their appeals spans social media, international forums, human rights organizations, and diplomatic channels, aiming to garner support and solidarity from around the world. The appeals made by Baloch activists for international solidarity emphasize the urgency of the situation and the need for support in exposing and addressing the brutality faced by the people of Balochistan. This call for solidarity is not just about raising awareness, but also about urging action to address the injustices and human rights violations occurring in the region. By rallying international support, Baloch activists hope to amplify their voices and push for tangible change and accountability from relevant authorities.
And with that, we come to the end of this edition of Newsweek South Asia. We'll be back next week with more news, views and analysis from the subcontinent. Meanwhile, do keep writing to us at nwsa@anin.com. This is Shivangi Mishra signing off on behalf of the entire production team of Newsweek South Asia. Goodbye and take care.